Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is NgRx with the latest updates from the Angular community in 100 seconds every week. At the Angular Community Meetup, Manfred Steyer presented an updated version of his talk about domain-driven design in Angular. He presented the team topologies model. One team is responsible for the platform services, another is specialized in certain technologies, then there is a supportive team, and those kind of teams who bring the business value. NgRx, the most popular state management library in Angular, was released in version 18. Making it compatible with Angular 18. Careful, if you want to use the signal store, it will become stable and is currently available only as a release candidate. To use it, install NgRx signals at next. Angular is downloaded 3.5 million times per week, which makes it the third most downloaded front-end framework next to React and Vue. 600,000 of those downloads are coming from Angular 9, which is very strange. Brandon Roberts now found out that Angular 9 is a dependency of Codelzyer. Codelzyer is a library we used before TypeScript ESLint came out, and it is very likely that Codelzyer is part of many applications, although it's not actively used, and developers should remove it. That would mean that the download numbers of Angular also would decrease by about 17%. WebAssembly allows us to run applications in the browser which have not been written in JavaScript, and in addition, the execution speed is almost like native code, so very fast. Evgeny Tupoltsev wrote an article where he shows you how to port an application written in Rust to WebAssembly and consume it in Angular. And that's it. Wishing you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.